ولكن تحديت الظروف وخضتها وحدي صبورا مستعينا بالصلاة.
كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي، كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أسى محنته، وكم كرهت مصابها.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، ما بعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Back 6 months ago, I released a video titled Ramadan Bouti, Betrayal, with a few question marks. As you can see on screen, whoever hasn't watched it, click the card and check that video out first before watching this one. Ramadan Bouti sided with the Alawi Nusayri regime from its inception, when Hafez al-Assad took over after the coup in the early 70s or late 70s, I can't really remember. To give a bit of background, I'm going to give you some historical context as well, but let me just go into the family that Ramadan Bouti supported from its inception until the day he died. The Assad family are Alawites originating from Kardaha, which is Alawite 100%. And their beliefs have been documented in the books of Ahlul Sunnah, Ibn Kathir, you know, Ibn Qayyim, Ibn Taymiyyah, and many others. So Ramadan Bouti supported the Alawite family, as I mentioned before, from its inception. And anyone who wants to argue now, I'm finding many of the abject defenders and blind followers that say, no, Bashar prays and he's Muslim and all the other things. Ibn Kathir, rahmatullah alayhi, in his Bidai wa Nihaya, the book that I got in my hand, documents a event in history which shows you the hatred of the Nusayriya, the Alawites, against Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, and what they did in history is just a repeat of what they are doing now. Ramadan Bouti supported them all the way. So let me just go into the event and then you'll understand, okay, this is, you know, a continuation. In the year 717, okay, 717, Ibn Kathir, rahmatullah alayhi, was alive during this time, because he died 774, so he's explaining what happened. وَحَمَلُوا عَلَى مَدِينَةِ جَبَلَةَ, that they basically took over a city in Syria called Jabala. Now this city is on the coast of Syria, so it's about roughly about 15 miles from Latakia. So it's basically a city in the northern part of Syria. قَتَلُوا خَلْقًا مِنْ أَهْلِهَا, that they killed many of its people, the Nusayriya. وَخَرَجُوا مِنْهَا يَقُولُونَ, and when they came to the city, they said, لَا إِلَهَا إِلَّا عَلِي, there is no God but Ali. وَلَا هِجَابَ إِلَّا مُحَمَّد, there is no barrier except Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَلَا بَابَ إِلَّا سَلْمَان, and they cursed Abu Bakr and Umar رضي الله عنه. وَصَاهَا أَهْلُ الْبَلَد, and the people of the land shouted out, وَإِسْلَامَا, أو إِسْلَام. فَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاصِرٌ وَلَا مُنْجِدٌ, and at that time there wasn't any particular helper or any, you know, savior. What the soldiers and the Shabiha of Bashar al-Assad, who Ramadan Bouti supported and called them and gave them honorific titles, and we'll get to that later, history's repeating itself. This was 717. What did they make them do? He said that they used to make the Muslims say, La ilaha illa Ali, wasjud li ilahika al-Mahdi, الذي يحيي ويميت. And what did Bashar soldiers Shabiha make the Muslims say? لا إله إلا بشار.
قل لا إله إلا بشار الأسد.
لا إله إلا بشار الأسد.
قل لا إله إلا بشار
الأسد.
أرفع بلاك.
لا إله إلا مهر الأسد. لا إله إلا مهر الأسد.
طلّي.
لا إله إلا مهر الأسد.
طلّي
لا
عرفه.
ما حكيك طلع فيه.
طلع فيني.
طلع فيه.
لك هذا الكاس.
لا مهر الأسد.
والله للعن.
لا إله إلا مهر الأسد.
محمود.
لا إله إلا
بشار الأسد. خذوه.
خذوه. خذوه. خذوه. خذوه. خذوه. خذوه. خذوه. خذوه.
خذوه. خذوه. خذوه.
And then they requested them to make sujood to their Mahdi, who apparently gives life and death, until they spilled their blood. You see, the crimes of the Nusayriya, Alawiya of the past is only repeating itself. It's only repeating itself. So I'm just giving you some context. Now, as I mentioned at the start, Hafez al-Assad took over the country by leading a coup. He was a military air marshal and he took over. Okay, it was a Ba'athist, it was a part of the Ba'athiyya. Now, Ramadan Bouti from day dot was a supporter of the regime, was a supporter of the regime. And when Hafez al-Assad took over, because he was from Qardaha and he was an Alawite, he needed to get religious legitimacy, right? So that he can officially take over.
وصل لسوريا عالم شيعي إيراني يدعى حسن مهدي الشيرازي أسس الحوزة الزينبية بدمشق ومن خلال فتوى أصدرها عام 76 حاول استعادة الفرع النصيري لأصله الشيعي وادعي أن كل علوي نصيري هو شيعي مذهب. قبلها بأربعين سنة كان العلويون قد طلبوا من فرنسا اعطاءهم دولة مستقلة لكونهم شعب يختلف عن الشعب المسلم السني.
الشعب العلوي الذي حافظ على استقلاله سنة فسنة بكثير من الغيرة والتضحيات الكبيرة في النفوس هو شعب يختلف بمعتقداته الدينية وعاداته وتاريخه عن الشعب المسلم السني.
فتوى الشيرازي سبقه إليها عام 1973 رجل الدين اللبناني موسى الصدر حين احتاج إليه الأسد الأب ليثبت حكمه بعد أن كان الدستور يشترط أن يكون رئيس الدولة مسلما لكون العلويين لا يعدون مسلمين عند الشيعة والسنة. أفتى الصدر وثبت الأسد حكمه بالرغم من الاعتراضات الشعبية.
So presenting some historical context, 12 Shia clerics, Musa al-Sadr and Shirazi, gave a fatwa to bring the Alawites into the body of the Shia, which basically made them legitimate and their people accepted them. So I'm going to show you later on in the video that Ramadan Bouti is no different to the pseudo-Salafis. They basically, you know, bend over backwards for tyrannical rulers. And he brings the Mas'ala, the same rhetoric as the pseudo-Salafis, because at the end of the day, they get some perks, don't they? But from now, I'm going to show you some various clips, okay? Now, whether I actually translate it in the video, depending if I get time, I may do it, I may not do it. So that's just a disclaimer right there. But even if I don't, I'll translate it anyway, all right? I'll translate it anyway. Now, Honorable Sufi Ash'aris, most notably the late Sheikh Sabuni, Rahmatullah Alayh, was a opponent of, Ramadan Bouti. And after his death, right, I'm going to show you clips. So this is going to be, you know, certain clips that were from part one, but I'm going to tie it in because then we get to the Mas'ala, which he basically was no different to the bootleggers from the pseudo Salafis. I'm showing you, obviously, is this a man that, you know, one should be honoring? No. Again, was he knowledgeable? Yes, of course. But then he stood against the believers. And as Sheikh Sabuni says, as you'll hear, he said, he ruled or judged upon himself with dhulm.
بالأمس شهد العالم كله مقتل عالم حكم على نفسه بالتبعية للظلم والطغيان على حساب الحق والعدل. لقد اختلفنا مع الشيخ البوطي منذ عهد المجرم المنافق حافظ الأسد إذ وقف إلى جانبه آنذاك ثم صلى عليه وقام على جنازته. ثم في هذه الثورة المباركة كان موقف البوطي مخالفا ليس للشعب السوري فقط بل خالف علماء الأمة قاطبة. لقد رأى علماء الأمة وجوب الخروج على مسيلمة الكذاب الذي يسمى بشار الأسد بعد أن استفحل طغيانه وإجرامه قتلا للبشر وتدميرا للحجر واعتدى على بيوت الله قصفا وتفجيرا ودنس كتاب الله وانتهك أعراض المؤمنات. فما كان من البوطي إلا أن أيده وأخذ بيده وأعانه على ظلمه وفجوره. قد تمادى البوطي في وصف الثوار حين سماهم عثالة وتمادى في وصف القتلة من جنود بشار حتى جعلهم في مصاف الصحابة ولو سكت لكان خيرا له. أقول إن الدكتور البوطي الذي أفضى إلى ربه قد حمل في عنقه دماء كثيرة. هم قتلة قتلوا علماء لبنان كالشيخ حسن خالد مفتي لبنان رحمه الله، وعشرة العلماء في سوريا، وأبوه الظالم حافظ الأسد قتل ما يزيد على 30,000 في حما وحدها.
انتفضت مدينة حما على استبداد النظام النصيري. قابل الأسد الانتفاضة الشعبية بالإبادة الجماعية.
نهار 2 شباط نحن قاعدين بالبيوت ما سمعنا إلا القصف والضرب وضرب المدافع، يعني من برا ما حد سجل يطلع من بيته. نهار 8 طلعونا غصب عنا بالضرب بالشتم وكسروا الباب ودخلوا علينا. طلعوا كلياتهم، طلعنا كل النسوان رفعوا ايدينا الحين ضلينا 3 ساعات رافعين ايدينا. نحن واقفين ولا شفنا ابو طلعنا ولا ضاربينه بالاربيجين مضروب كلياته وفوق اهالي في بقلبه ما حد عارف يعني من جوا ولا ما الاولاد صاروا لهم شوي كل لا ومره مقسوم نصها والكلب انطرف عم ياكل وفي راس ولد صغير والاب منعرف حاطط على راسه.
في اخر السبعينات واوائل الثمانينات كانت هنالك مشكله بين الدوله والاخوان المسلمين، فدعي ثلي من العلماء علماء دمشق إلى الرئيس حافظ أسد آنذاك، وأنا كنت واحد من
So you heard the harsh words from Sheikh Sabuni rahmatullah alayh, and this is the reality. This is what the fanatics won't tell you. He stood with Hafez al-Assad. He was with Hafez al-Assad. He didn't critique Hafez al-Assad after the Hama massacre where 30,000 people were murdered, you know, indiscriminately. And also, Sheikh Sabuni rahmatullah alayh mentioned that not only did he oppose the Syrian people, he went against the Ummah and various other things, as you heard.
حسن نصر الله. والله ليس بين أفراد هذا الجيش وبين أن يكونوا في رتبة أصحاب رسول الله إلا أن يرعوا حق الله في أنفسهم. يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يسر له سبيل ذلك، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اشرح صدره
لي. هذا بيان للناس. يا أسفا على علماء هذا العصر من المنافقين المذبذبين الذين وقفوا بجانب الطغاة يساندونهم على الباطل يضللون الأمة باسم الدين، أمثال المفتي أحمد حسون والدكتور البوطي وأمثالهما، يرون بأم أعينهم ما يفعله الطاغية الظالم بشار الأسد وزبانيته من قتل للمسلمين وهدم لبيوت الله وتمزيق للمصاحف وإكراه للمعتقلين على قول الكفر الصريح كقول هؤلاء لا إله إلا بشار، يأمرون المعتقلين بالسجود على صور الطاغية.
رمضان بوتي comparing the Sahaba to this the Syrian army who were massacring Muslims, you know, all sorts of making dua for Bashar al-Assad, wants to be the finger of Hassan Nasrallah. Now, what makes it worse is that he adds religious legitimacy to Bashar al-Assad. Okay, he adds religious legitimacy to Bashar al-Assad, citing the same sources as the neo-Salafis. So when, you know, they become bootlickers, right, they do whatever's possible to take statements out of context and not present the balanced view regarding this mas'ala. Okay, let's now listen to Ramadan Bouti.
ما حكم الشرع بالنسبة للخروج على رئيس الدولة؟ بالمختصر وقد سمعتم الآن طرفا أو مختصرا من الجواب، لكن سأتحدث عن جانب آخر وسأتحدث عن الأدلة والبراهين. يقول لنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مهما كان الحاكم جائرا فاسقا منحرفا يجب السمع والطاعة ولا يجوز الخروج عليه إلا إذا رأينا كفرا بواحا. يقول، لاحظوا ما يقول في حديث طويل، سيكون من بعد ولاة قلوبهم قلوب شياطين في جسمان إنس لا يهتدون بهداية ولا يستنون بسنة. فسأله حذيفة بن طيبة: ماذا نصنع إذا وجدنا أنفسنا أمام هؤلاء الولاة؟ قال: تسمع وتطيع، وإن ضرب ظهرك وأخذ مالك تسمع وتطيع، إلا أن تروا كفرا بواحا لكم عليه من الله سلطان. إذا رأينا ولي الأمر ارتكب معصية لا نأمره بالمعروف وننهاه عن المنكر، لتأمرن بالمعروف ولتنهون عن المنكر، أو ليسلط الله عليكم شراركم فيدعو خياركم فلا يستجاب لهم. هذا كلام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. الخروج على الحاكم إذا لم نجد كفرا بواحا، بل وجدنا مظاهر الدين والإيمان فيه خلاف. هنالك أناس في بعض الأقنية يخيلون إلينا أن المسألة ذات يعني أبعاد مختلفة وخلاف، لا والله ليست مسألة خلافية، أجمعت الأمة على هذا. وها أنا أنقل لكم كلام إمام من أئمة كثيرين ينقلون الإجماع. الإمام النووي معروف، الإمام النووي يقول: وأما الخروج عليهم على أئمة المسلمين وقتالهم فحرام بإجماع المسلمين وإن كانوا فاسقين ظالمين، وقد تظاهرت الأحاديث الكثيرة في بيان ذلك. نعم، هذا كلام الأئمة وليس كلام الإمام النووي فقط.
Just to add as well, Bashar al-Assad is a kafir Nusayri. So he's already contradicting himself because they don't apply to him. Again, based on Qudra, Shawka, Mana'a, even if they are kuffar, you have to have, you know, the ability to obviously remove him. All of these things are from the, you know, subsidiary matters and his ijtihad, etc. So just to get that out there, all of these ahadith that he's presenting, etc., they don't apply to Bashar. So that's the one thing I can't get in the first place. Number two, he quotes Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayh, okay, no problem, okay, and this is what the neo-Salafis present as well. Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayh died in the 7th century, okay, died in the 7th century. So if he's citing an ijma'ah, if it's a binding ijma'ah, a ijma' mustaqir, there would be, you know, no opposition going forward, especially from the mujtahid imams, right? Khatib al-Sharbini was one of the leading imams of the Shafi'iyya, one of the leading imams of the Shafi'iyya, right? And what he presents shows that Ramadan Bouti was following the political winds, again, the same way the pseudo-Salafis do, to defending his master. And Khatib al-Sharbini shows what the position was from amongst this, the Shafi'iyya, from the Ashab of the Madhab. Okay, and what does he say? As you can see on screen, we've got the book Mughni al-Muhtaj, and he died in the 10th century, I think. Muslimun, meaning the Bughat. Okay, so if he wants to claim that those who rebel against Bashar are Bughat, meaning transgressors, because they could be bughat from Ahlul Haqq, etc., etc. So he mentioned the hum Muslimun, mukhaliful imam, that they oppose the imam. Walau ja'iran hum adilun kama qalahu al-qaffal. Okay, that they are Muslims who oppose the imam even if he is oppressive, and the rebels are just according to al-qaffal. Ramadan Bouti never mentioned that they were just. He was opposing them. Anyway, let's carry on. However, Ibn al-Qushayri transmits from the majority of the Shafi'iyah, and that which is in the great commentary on al-Rawda, that they are rebels only. Okay, they are only what? They are only rebels if the imam is just. Okay? They are only rebels if the imam is just. So if they're unjust, they're not rebels. They're qawmun min ahlul haq. And then we're going to get to al-Ghazali, who mentioned that. But just bear with me for a sec. That is, likewise, this criteria is mentioned in Al-Umm of Imam Shafi'i and Al-Mukhtasar. And basically, he carries on. Then he mentions the evidence that is cited, that the statement of the author, Imam Nawawi, rahmatullahi alayhi, in his commentary in Sahih Muslim, that rebelling against the head of state rule and fighting them is not permissible according to the consensus of the Muslims. But what did he say? However, this consensus is disputed, or has been disputed, by the rebellion of Al-Husayn against Yazid, the son of Muawiyah, and Ibn Zubayr against Abdul Malik ibn Marwan, and they were both supported by large groups or a huge number of the Salaf. And some say, وَقَدْ يُقَالْ, that these consensus were arrived at after these events. Yes, some have claimed it, but it's not going to bind ijma. And some others differentiate between rebelling against the ruler who came into power by force, meaning al-mutaghallib, which is khuruj in the first place, and the one that is basically given the bay'ah by sworn in basically with like peaceful means, and they consider that impermissible. Okay, so as I mentioned, the statement of al-Shabini, who was 2 centuries after and is a grand imam himself, mujtahid, proved that the ijma'ah regarding the khuruj against the ja'ir or zalim is speculation and assumption, because as I said, Khatib al-Shabini mentions it. Okay, so now, okay, Ramadan Bouti says the same thing. Pseudo-Salafis also say the same thing. The evidences are the same. The argumentation is the same. So what did I show you? They are slaves to the rulers. They are bootlickers. And Bashar al-Assad, from all people, 2 years, because the Syrian revolution, the Thawra Mubarakah, started in 2011. Obviously, in 2013, 2 years in, what was the cause? They were protesting for their rights, you know, fiscal policies, you know, they wanted jobs, etc. And the military and the Shabiha were slaughtering the people, peaceful protesters. So during that time, Ramadan Bouti was against the Syrian people. What happened in 2014, post-2014, when Dawaish came from Iraq, etc., that was after, okay? Then the world powers got involved. And when Ramadan Bouti was alive, that was during 2011, 2013, but it was with the regime, when they were dropping barrel bombs. That was the early, you know, period, when the regime was just indiscriminately, Dar'a, Hims, Halab, you know, and various other areas as well, Tadmur, etc., etc., Dir Azor. So you heard Ramadan Bouti present the hadith of Kufrun Bawahan, right? Kufr Bawahan, the Alawi regime upon Kufr, and his Bawahan as well. So it's just, I don't know, he obviously must have the view that they're Muslims. Anyway, this Kufr Bawahan, he presented Imam Nawawi regarding the Ijma'ah, right, which wasn't a binding Ijma'ah, which isn't correct. But what we'll show you now is, what was Imam Nawawi's position regarding Kufrun Bawahan? What does this Kufrun Bawahan mean? Okay, as you can see on screen. So in my hand, I've got Sahih Muslim, alright? Sahih Muslim of the Sharh Nawawi, Rahmatullah alayhi. Wal muradu bil kufri huna al ma'siyah, that the intent of this kufr, Kufrun Bawahan, the intent, what is meant of the kufr here is ma'siyah, is sin. Did Ramadan Bouti speak the haq? وَقُولُوا بِالْحَقِّ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ, speak the haq wherever you are, according to Imam Nawawi. And the kufr in this hadith, according to Imam Nawawi, means ma'asiyah. Okay, some have said, and I'm going to get to it now, what Ibn Hajar brings, and I'll bring it now. Okay, so as you can see in my hand, I've got Fatul Bari by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. And he presents the exact statement as Imam Nawawi. As you can see, قَالَ نَوَوِي الْمُرَادُ بِالْكُفْرِ هُنَا الْمَعْسِيَةِ وَمَعْنَى الْحَدِيثِ لَا تُنَازِئُوا ولا الأمور في ولايتهم ولا تعترضوا عليهم إلا أن تروا منهم منكرا محققا تعلمونه من قواعد الإسلام. And the others have said that this means sins and kufr. Then he presents a statement from الداودي. He says ونقل ابن طين عن داودي قال الذي عليه العلماء في الأمراء الجور. They mentions that some of the ulama have narrated that the oppressive leaders, if you've got the ability to remove them without any fitna and without any oppression, is wajib. If not, then you have to have sabr. Then he said, some of them have said that you should not even give rulership to a fasiq in the first place. But then look what it mentions. فَإِنْ أَحْدَثَ جَوْرًا بَعْدَ أَنْ كَانَ عَدْلًا, that if he becomes tyrannical after he was just, فَاخْتَلَفُوا فِي جَوَازِ الْخُرُوجِ عَلَيْهِ, but then they differed. The ulama, the scholars differed if it's permissible or not. Then he mentions, but the correct position is, so there's a difference of opinion, but the correct position is that you should not do khuruj except when you see kufr, then it is wajib to do khuruj. Okay, coming back to me now, we go back to Fathul Bari by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. The Ghazali mentions the two types of people that rebel, and the second group has two types. And the second one of the two groups, he mentions that those who rebel against the rulers because they rebelled angrily for their religion due to the oppression of their rulers and them leaving up the sunnah, and they are the people of truth. Okay, they are the people of truth, and amongst them are Hussein bin Ali and the people of Medina in Harra, and the Crusaders who rebelled against Hajjaj. And the second group now, okay, that of the two groups. So he's got the second group, and this one has two groups. So the second now group of the two groups mentions that the ones that seek power only, regardless whether they had a doubt or not, they are bughat. Okay, they are bughat. So you got the people that rebel angrily for the religion, they are upon the people of truth. Then you got those who basically rebel just for power. Okay, just for rebel for power. So you see the emphasis here, right? That Ramadan Bouti was a scholar that betrayed the knowledge that he gained. He betrayed the knowledge he gained. And he stood with an Alawi Nusayri kafir. And that kafir has been responsible for the past 11 to 12 years in indiscriminately killing the Syrian people. Okay, and let's not mention about the prison. So as you can see on screen, we've got a report from Amnesty International. Okay, and it mentions human slaughterhouse, mass hangings and extermination at Saydania prison, Syria. Neo-Salafis, the pseudo-Salafis, and these ghulat of the Sufiya, these fanatics, have more in common than they can imagine, right? All the information we presented, Ramadan Bouti, as you know, Sheikh Sabuni mentioned, he judged upon himself in following zulm and tyranny. And he served the regime from its inception, as I presented, and I didn't leave any stone unturned. These fanatic Sufis, these ghullat, have to understand that you are no different from these neo-Salafi, pseudo-Salafi bootlickers. And Ramadan Bouti, to me, was a betrayer. He betrayed the Syrian people. And that's not me who said that. I'm following on from Sheikh Sabuni. And if you're going to be blind to all the information presented in this video, it's a lengthy video, part two, you know, I've already done a part one. I can't fathom how blind these neo-Sufis, ghullat, these extremists, fanatics are. They are so blind, it really shows that they have too much in common with their pseudo-Salafi counterparts. And Ramadan Bouti went against the benefit, the rights of the Muslims, and he defended Hafez al-Assad, supported him and his son until the last breath. Control your frustrations, ghullat Sufiya. We're not going to stop against highlighting the betrayal, the treachery of your scholars. And you cannot point your fingers at the neo-pseudo-Salafis when you yourselves and your scholars are also falling in the same mistakes. So take care of yourselves. Wa salla ala nabiyyina Muhammad.
Wajjih risala wa raga' min shaykhna al-kareem an yuwajjih risala ila al-ulama' arju an tanzamu ila al-shaykh Kurayim Rajah al-lazhi a'lana min waqtin mubakkirin bara'atahum ma yaf'aluhu al-nizam wa a'tadhiru ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala min kulli alimin wa awaluhum al-mufti al-lazhi يعني أفتى بعدم جواز الخروج على الحاكم.
والدكتور البوطي.
والدكتور البوطي سامحه الله يعني على.
سامحه الله, عمله الله بما يستحق. أسأل الله أن يعمله بما يستحق.
ليس الغريب غريب الشام واليمني, إن الغريب غريب الأحد والكفن, إن الغريب له حق لغربته على المقيمين في الأوطان والسكن. سفر بعيد وزاد لي يبلغني, وقوتي ضعفت والموت يطلبني. ما أحلم الله عني حيث أمهلني, وقد تماديت في ذنبي ويسترني. تمر ساعة